Picatrix, Book 3, Chapter 5, Section 5. The reception of the planetary spirits, according to the opinion of the ancients, is as follows. First, it behooves you to know about the planet's nature you desire to use for the reception of its powers and spirits, and to gather their powers into the chosen figure or image, as well as the nature of things connected to a specific planet, namely on colors, foods, incenses, and suffumigations. Then, ensure that the color of the surface of the image's body be a similar color to that of the chosen planet. The incense to the incenses, and the color of the image's clothes, and those of the operator, must also be suited to the color of the chosen planet. So too should the suffumigations belong to the incenses suited to that planet. For wealth, beseech Jupiter. See Picatrix, Book 4, Chapter 4, Section 6. The inner body of the operator should belong to the nature of that planet, that is, he should eat foods assigned to the chosen planet as much as one should for that operator's body to sustain a complexion of humors suited to that chosen planet. If by chance such food was contrary to your own nature, eat only a little and moderately at first. Eating little by little, you temper the stomach until it is used to such things. As you eat these foods, you increase your appetite for them until the body is mastered and nourished. When the body is thus mastered, observe where the planet stands in the zodiac of signs, and that its rays be projected in straight lines toward the Earth and not intersected by the rays of other contrary planets. Let the rays be poured down into the earth directly with every obstacle removed. Then, take some metals suited to the chosen planet from which you should smelt a cross. Do this in the appropriate constellation and make it 2 feet high. Combine it with one of the aforementioned figures or images matching with your petition and that planet's spirit. For example, if you wish to create an image for fighting and crushing or terrifying enemies, place the cross over an image of a lion or snake. If you wish to operate for fleeing and evading, place the cross over the image of a bird. If your work involved increasing wealth, power, honor, and social standing, place the cross over an image of a man sitting on a throne. Make all your petitions according to these kinds of examples by placing the cross over a figure suited to your petition. If you desire for anyone to obey you and not transgress your orders, make an image of the person on a stone appropriate to the planet's nature that has the greatest power in the root of their nativity and ascendant. Make the image in that planet's hour, and the planet ruling their nativity should be neither in opposition, nor in the same sign, nor in any aspect with any planet contrary to it. Once you've done these things perfectly, place the image such that it may be the one propping up the other principal figure. The reason this figure is made in the shape of a cross has been explained, that is, because everything gathers its own powers from the figures relative to their respective qualities, and everything avoids its contraries. We seek the powers of the planetary spirits so that they might join their own figures, but we do not comprehend the form of spirit, nor could we understand it by experience, except in the form of a human, animal, or another thing. We thus conclude that every power of the planets manifests most powerfully in images. We see that all the figures and forms of trees and plants are diverse in their shapes, as are likewise the forms of animals and minerals. Since we could never fully comprehend the forms of the planetary spirits, the ancient sages of this art chose the cross as a universal figure. This is because all bodies have a surface, and the surface of an image has a longitude and a latitude. And the cross is the appropriate image for longitude and latitude. Therefore, we have said that This image is the universal tool in these rituals, and the receptacle of the planetary spirit's powers, because they work well with other images. This is one of the secrets of this art. Furthermore, all humans have a place beneath the seven circles of the planets. When the power of a planetary spirit is joined with the shape of a cross, then the ritual has strength and power over whatever other image is with it. Were it made in the image of a human, its power would pour out onto humankind, and it is likewise with the images of other animals. When you will have made these images thus, make a censer out of the same material as the cross such that it is completely enclosed except at the top where a hole should allow smoke to exit. The smoke of burning substances should not escape elsewhere. Moreover, have a building set aside into which only those involved in your ritual may enter, if at all possible, and only at the time of performance. This building should have a place exposed to the heavens. It should be decked in herbs of that ritual's ruling planet alone. There ought to be nothing in it other than those herbs. Then, inhale the fumigations according to the chosen planet's nature. Burn it in the fire of that censer. Place the cross above the censer in such a way that the smoke exiting from the censer may enter through the lower parts of the cross and flow through to the upper parts. All these things should occur in an appropriately selected hour with the ritual's ruling planet being as mentioned. These orders having been fulfilled carefully, the smoke of the suffumigation ought to reach the sphere of the signs in a straight line. It should not be intersected by the rays of other planets, contrary to the elected planet. If your ritual involved those things of the lesser world, the planetary spirit should be harnessed, and its power should descend through its own rays down to the earth into the ritual. Then the thing sought will be fulfilled. Picatrix, Book 1, Chapter 5, Section 11. An image for increasing wealth and trade. Make an image and let the ascendant, the tenth house, their lords, the lord of the house of the ascendant's lord, and the lord of the house of the tenth house's lord, the moon, the lord of her house, also the second house and its lord, be fortunate. Let the lord of the second house receive the lord of the ascendant in a trine or sextile aspect. Let a fortunate planet be in the second house. Let the part of fortune be in the ascendant or the tenth house, with the lord of that part of fortune facing it with a favorable aspect. Let the 11th house and its lord likewise be fortunate. Once this image is complete, guard it, keep it secret and out of sight. You will profit in whatever you do, and you will succeed in all your efforts. Picatrix, Book 2, Chapter 10, Section 43. The Image of Jupiter. From the works of Jupiter, make the shape of a man crowned and sitting on a throne with 4 feet. Each of these feet should be on a man's neck, and all those 4 men should have wings. The man who sits on the throne should raise his hands just as those giving a speech do. Do this in the hour of Jupiter, while he is in the ascendant and in his own exaltation. Engrave this on a clear and white stone. Whoever carries this image will be raised into riches and honor. He will live out the best life and have many sons. He will accomplish what he desires. All endeavors wherein his effort is spent will end well, and no enemy will be able to harm him. Picatrix, Book 2, Chapter 11, Section 32, Regarding the Deckhands. In the third face of Capricorn ascends a man holding a book for himself to open and close. Before him, he has the tail of a fish. This is the face for riches, the accumulation of money, and for gathering and growing businesses inclined toward a positive.